This morning's scripture is from Leviticus 23, verses 39 to 43. This is the word of God. Now, the 15th day of the seventh month, you have gathered in the produce of the land. You shall keep the festival of the Lord, lasting 7 days, a complete rest on the first day, and a complete rest on the eighth day. On the first day you shall take the fruit of the majestic trees, branches of palm trees, boughs of leafy trees, and willows of the brook, and you shall rejoice before the Lord your God for 7 days. You shall keep it as a festival to the Lord 7 days in the year, and you shall keep it in the seventh month as a statute forever throughout your generations. You shall live in booths for 7 days. All that are citizens of Israel shall live in booths, so that your generations may know that I made the people of Israel live in booths when I brought them out of the land of Egypt. I am the Lord your God.
It was so humbling
to feel literally, and maybe this is because I'm blind, but to literally feel the whole earth shaking and everything around you moving, and you felt how small you were. And yet, how wonderful that I was here, that I existed, that I was part of this wonderful world. And it's an amazing, it's an amazing feeling. This combination of fear and excitement and joy and thankfulness. And it all combines together in these events that happen in our lives. And it also just combines throughout the year, through the seasons. Now, today's scripture, we read Leviticus. And that's generally a text people try to avoid because it's about the laws and it 7 days of the seventh month and you do this. But there's always a reason for all of those laws. And it can be actually quite fascinating when you start to delve into this. So what was today's scripture about? Well, it's actually very relevant because if you travel past, it is about, well, because today is about the festival of Sukkot, otherwise known as the festival of booths, or the festival of tabernacles. And if you go by our friends down at the B'nai Tikva synagogue today, you will see a strange little hut, tent thing in front of their synagogue. And if you're observant, you will see these same huts, little shelters, in the yards of many of your Jewish neighbors. And you may overhear your Jewish neighbors say things like lulav, itrav, sukkot, and wonder what that's all about. Well, this is all the festival of Sukkot. And this is right here in our scripture book, Leviticus 21. Sukkot is a harvest festival that comes right after the opening of the Jewish year with Yom Kippur and Rosh Hashanah, and then it goes into Sukkot. It's called the High Holy Days. This is part of the High Holy Days. And for the traditions of Sukkot, the first thing that they do, and it's commanded here in Leviticus, is to build a temporary shelter, to build a house to live in that's not permanent, but something that can be easily knocked over by the wind or the rain or the storm. In fact, one of the requirements of a good sukkah, which is the name of this shelter, this booth, this tabernacle, is that you need to be able to see the stars by looking out from the roof. So a lot of people use reeds and leaves and netting to make the roof. And then, the reason for all this is to remind people of how temporary all things are. It's to remind the Israeli people of their exodus from Egypt and the 40 years they spent in the wilderness, where they could have been wiped out by a sandstorm, but they had to depend on the grace of God. And they lived in tents, and everything was temporary, except for their faith in God. And then, you're supposed to, the tradition is that you live in this sukkah for 7 days, and celebrate. You decorate the sukkah with all of the wonderful gifts that God has given. Fruits and vegetables and gourds. And you spend traditionally you spend all 7 days in the sukkah. In a modern tradition, it's more you eat meals in the sukkah and you sleep in the sukkah. And you sing songs and you have generally a festival. Because it's a harvest, in its true nature, this festival of Sukkot is a harvest festival. And it's actually a very practical thing because back in ancient Israel, at this time, it was an agricultural society and everybody was out harvesting their crops. And so they would all live in temporary shelters anyway. So why not make it into a party?
and celebrate all the gifts that God has given us. And the next major tradition in Sukkot is to make what's called the lulav and the etrog, the four species. And the lulav is this wand that you make out of willow branches, palm branches, and myrtle branches. And you tie them together. And then you get this etrog, which is a beautiful lemon-like fruit. And the Bible says you're supposed to use them, but it really doesn't say how. So it kind of was confusing. And the rabbis got together and they made a consensus that you use these four species to give a blessing of thanksgiving. And so you go into the sukkah, this temporary shelter, and you give thanks. You wave the lulav and the etrog in the six sacred directions of north, east, south, and west, and of the heavens, and of the earth. And you give thanks. And then it also is a bit of a blessing for the next season to come, which would be the planting season, and it's a blessing for rain. And all of this is to give thanks. You give thanks for all the abundance that you have while standing in a temporary shelter. Because everything around us may disappear, but God and God's love endures forever. And that happens in all of these fall festivals. I'm kind of sad in some ways that Christianity doesn't have a fall festival. Unless you count Halloween or Holy Eve and All Saints Day and All Souls Day. Because fall is kind of an amazing time. And all the cultures that celebrate the fall festival have the same paradox between a joyful celebration of the harvest and all that is around us, the sights, the smells, the sounds, the tastes. And yet, there's this fear of winter. The days are getting darker, and the times when we might have nothing. And there is this lesson of, because things are temporary, we need to be joyful and thankful for what we have now. And I think this could be applied to us. Everything in this church, in a way, to be temporary. This building will not last forever. But the God we worship will. This is not my church or your church or even our church. This is God's church. This is our sukkah, our temporary shelter. And yet, we can give thanks for it. We can give thanks that God will be forever, and we are people of God. We walk hand in hand with God. And therefore, we need to seize the day and enjoy the gifts that we have today. The gifts of the harvest of God, which is all of you, faithful Christians here, to praise and worship and work towards the kingdom of God. And there is a promise that if we do this, in the end days, all will be thankful. That the temporariness, the uncertainty, the fear that follows these seasons of harvest will be gone. Harvest and thanksgiving. So the harvest is here. Let us not squander it, but use it to its fullest extent and be thankful.